food, good manners, and proper drinking.
Bourbon is king in South Carolina. And for being the holy city, there's a lot of drinking going on.
Non-holiness going on. Preserving that culture is the gin joint, specializing in expertly crafted pre-prohibition cocktails. And in those days, some of today's go-to spirits weren't even on the menu.
I'm pretty much a vodka girl, like that's usually my poison, so am I definitely in the wrong place?
We don't have vodka here, but not because we're called the gin joint.
Okay.
We just wanted people to come here and try something out of the ordinary.
While keeping their libations unique, the gin joint takes the art of crafting cocktails very seriously. From the mixers to the ice, every ingredient is handmade. In the 1920s, ice makers didn't exist. A fact Joe doesn't take lightly.
Seems like a lot of work for the cocktail. You feel like it's definitely worth it, huh?
If you look at this ice, it's perfectly clear, which is visually really attractive in a drink, but also the ice inside of a really large block is a lot colder.
I cut my kill.
To pair with their bold cocktails, Joe's wife and partner, Mary Elena, handcrafts what the gin joint calls defiant bar food.
Since day one, we've been known for our soft pretzels. We make the dough, roll it, we use a nice local Bull's Bay sea salt on top, and then we serve it with a spicy sriracha cheese sauce.
Ooh,
I want to get down and dirty with this pretzel dough. Charleston's a foodie place, isn't it?
It really is. There's so much competition here now, so many great restaurants, and you know, our focus is the food, although once you start having a drink or two, I mean, who doesn't want like a salty or sweet snack to kind of go with it?
I definitely do.